fascinating world of trivia, where even a right answer can catch you in a trap. On Trivia Trap. The juniors are ready. The seniors are set to play. And here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob Eubanks.
One more time. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Trivia Trap. We hope you had a really nice weekend, and we're ready to play our game on this Monday morning. So I tell you what, let's do. Let's meet our two competing teams. We'll begin right over here with our seniors. At least... They don't act like seniors, but they are seniors. And Jordan, how are you?
Yes, I'm just fine. My name is Jordan Fredrickson. I'm a structural draftsman.
Well, good. Nice to have you with us. Linda.
Hi, I'm Linda Fine. I'm a realtor.
Good. And Brooke.
My name is Brooke Brain. I'm a neonatal intensive care nurse.
You're a what?
Neonatal intensive care nurse.
I just want to see you say it twice. All right, our seniors. Round trivia chat today. And let's welcome back our returning champions, the juniors. Yesterday, they did real well. They won a little over $12,000. And who won the big money? Leanna won the big money. Greg, you began then.
Hi, Bob. I'm Greg Gagarinas, and I'm a recent graduate of the University of California at Santa Barbara.
Congratulations, and welcome back. Dori.
Hi. My name is Dori Wolfenstein, and I work for a telecommunications company.
And the lady who won over $11,000 yesterday
is
Leanna.
And we're going to do it again.
Yeah. My name's Leanne Kanan, and I'm a recent graduate of Cal State Northridge in radio, TV, broadcasting.
Welcome the juniors to Trivia Tap. Yes. All right, let's play our game. We're going to begin with the seniors, as we always do. Jordan, you have to make the decision for those two lovely ladies who are sitting beside you. Here's what happened. We're going to show you two rows of answers. I want you to choose either the top row or the bottom row. Up on the top row, we have these answers. Sweep, Bravo, Natural, and Huevos. And on the bottom row, take a look at these. Steven Spielberg, Clint Eastwood, Mark Goodson, Dudley Moore. Will it be the top or the bottom for you, seniors?
I think I'll, let's go bottom.
All right.
The bottom row.
Bottom.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Everybody says okay. Here we go. Here's your question now. Which of these men has a star on the Hollywood Boulevard Walk of Fame? Now, one of those answers is the right answer. What you must do as a team is cut all three wrong answers. If you do that, you get $300. Jordan?
I'll cut Dudley Moore.
Dudley Moore.
Okay.
Good choice. Good choice, Jordan.
Let's see how the seniors are going to do with this one. How about cutting Dudley Moore? Yes. Linda, find another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut Steven Spielberg.
Good choice.
You don't think he has?
I don't think he does yet.
Really? I thought Spielberg...
I don't know.
Well, we'll see together, won't we?
Yes, we sure
will. Can we cut the answer, Steven Spielberg? Yes. Oh, I remember. I think he did his handprint, didn't they, at the Grauman's Theater, at the Chinese Grauman's. So he does not have a star.
Not yet.
Be darn. Brooke, here's what you have to do. Two of those answers up there... Mm-hmm. One is right, one is wrong. You must find the wrong answer. If you do, your team gets $300. Which of these men has a star in the Hollywood Boulevard Walk of Fame?
Cut the I'm final going to cut answer. Mark Goodson.
Yay!
Just talking about the man that signs my checks. I wish you wouldn't say that with such bravado. My new word today, folks. Can we, let's not say cut. Can we, let's not say eliminate.
Come on.
Could we remove Mark Goodson from up there?
Gotcha,
didn't we? Yes, yes. Mark Goodson has a star on Hollywood Boulevard's Walk of Fame. And I have a note here from him that says, please forgive me for this question. I guess I just wanted to brag a little bit. We're going to let the boss do that. You did eliminate two, though. So you get $100 over here. Seniors, you're on your way. And let's go right over to our juniors, returning champions. Now, Greg, Sweep, Bravo, Natural, and Huevos. And on the bottom, juniors, you'll find these. All Quiet on the Western Front, Gone with the Wind, Birth of a Nation, and It Happened One Night. Greg, top or bottom?
We'll go with the bottom, Bob.
With the bottom row? I thought you'd take the top row. That's all right. What do I know? What was the first moving picture ever shown at the White House? First moving picture ever shown at the White House. Cut the wrong answers, and you're on your way, Greg.
Take away All Quiet on the Western Front, Bob.
All Quiet on the Western Front you would like to cut? Let's see if you can. Cut that one, please. It's a good choice. Dori. First moving picture ever shown at the White House. You must find another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut It Happened One Night.
It Happened One Night.
Good answer.
Let's eliminate It Happened One Night. You're safe again. All right, Leanne, all up to you. Find the last wrong answer. Your team gets $300 and take a pretty good lead in this game.
It's all up to me. I will cut Gone with the Wind.
Gone with the Wind?
Yeah. Yeah.
I wouldn't have cut that. Let's see if you're right or if I'm right. Cut the answer, Gone with the Wind.
Yeah!
Naturally, the correct answer is Birth of a Nation. Yeah! On February the 15th, 1916, President Woodrow Wilson saw a movie at the White House for the very first time. It was Bambi Goes to Hollywood and, no, Birth of a Nation. You have $300, right. $100 for the seniors. We must pause for these words. We'll be right back with more Trivia Tap in just a moment from now. Trivia Tap. Our juniors have $300. They're our returning champions, won a little over $12,000 as a team yesterday. And our new senior group, they have $100. And let me tell you, it's the team that gets to $1,000 that wins the game has a chance to play for $10,000. So let's continue with round one of Trivia Tap. And Linda will go right to you. You make the choice for your team. Sweet Bravo Natural Huevos on top. Mm-hmm. And on the bottom, seniors, here they are. Bob Hope and Bing Crosby, Gabby Hayes, Sancho Panza, and Joseph and the Virgin Mary. Top or bottom?
I'm going to try the bottom. It looks interesting. My teammates are going to kill me.
Well, let's see. Here's your question. Who rode a mule named Dapple? Who rode a mule named Dapple?
Hmm.
You must cut the three wrong answers. And Linda, you can begin.
All right, I'm going to cut Bob Hope and Bing Crosby.
Good. That'd be a pretty good-sized mule, wouldn't it? All right, let's cut that answer. Bob Hope and Bing Crosby. Yes.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Brooke, cut another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut Joseph and the Virgin Mary. Good answer?
Good answer.
It's almost as bad as Mark Goodson. I wish to be very careful. Let's eliminate the answer. Joseph and the Virgin Mary.
Yeah! Yeah! Okay, Jordan.
What are you clapping about, Jordan? The pressure's on you now. Who rode a mule named Dapple? Find the last wrong answer for me, Jordan.
Well, I'm going to cut Sancho Panza.
Oh, yeah! Good answer! Good one, Jordan.
You think Gabby Hayes rode a mule named Dapple?
Definitely.
Well, let's see. For $300, cut Sancho Panza.
Oh!
All right, trivia buffs, do you know who Sancho Panza is?
That's right, over there,
Junior's name. Don Quixote's sidekick. Sancho Panza rode a mule named Dapple. Just something that you need to know in life, isn't it? All right, you did eliminate two of them, though, so we'll give you another $100, and that means that our seniors now have $200. Junior, you have $300, and Dori, here we go. Sweet Bravo Natural and Huevos on top. On the bottom, new group for you. Here we are. Liger, Tiglin, Tyron, and Regal.
I'll go for the top.
Good. Here we go. In bullfighting, one of these words describes a movement of the bullfighter's cape. Which one is it? One of those describes the movement of a bullfighter's cape. Which one? Find the wrong answer. Story began.
Okay, I'm going to cut huevos. I know my...
You mean ole is not O-L-A-Y as an egg. All right. Can we cut huevos?
Yeah. I know my thing too well.
All right. Now, here we go, Leanne. Find another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut natural.
We'll cut the natural.
Exactly.
All right, let's cut the answer natural.
Hey, didn't sound...
You see,
Spanish to me.
I know, you got one, though, so we'll give you another $50. Let me tell you about the natural is a low-sweeping movement of the cape created to induce the bull to pass low and to the left of the bullfighter, something like...
Mm. All right.
He goes right through there. That's the natural.
Okay. Now I know.
Now you know. See, you learn all kinds of things, don't you? All right, $350 for our juniors, $200 for our seniors, and we never did get to Liger, Tiglin, Tyron, and Regal, so we get to play Trivia Trap with you at home. This is a fun question. Believe it or not, a male lion can mate with a female tiger. She doesn't like it. But what are the cubs called? What are the cubs called? Ligers, Tiglin, Tyron, or Regal? We'll be back to tell you the answer to that question and play our trivia race right after this. the trivia trap. How'd you do with our question? Well, believe it or not, a male lion can mate with a female tiger. What are the cubs called? They're called ligers. L-I-G-E-R, ligers. All right, let's go back to our game between our juniors and our seniors. Juniors have $350. The seniors have $200. That's going to be important because we're going to play our trivia race right now until one of our teams gets to $1,000. So if you're ready, come with me. And here we go with our race. As I said, we're playing until a team gets to $1,000. The first team to get to $1,000 then has a chance to play for $10,000. Juniors, returning champions, are in front. I told you it was important. That means they get to go first. And in the trivia race, every question is worth $100. However, after the 10th question, the values will then double. Now, each team will have three chances to come up with the correct answer. If all three of you miss, control then goes over to the other team. So, juniors, we're going to start with you. Greg, you get to pick the question. Will it be candy, business, or DJ?
Let's go with candy.
Candy. For $100, you have $350. You're trying to get to $1,000. The race is on. Here we go. Before they became multi-flavored, what was the first flavor of Lifesavers?
Peppermint.
That's right, peppermint. All right, you have $450. Dori, pick a question.
I'll go for DJ.
DJ, here's your question. By what name is radio DJ Bob Smith better known? Leanne.
Wolfman Jack.
Yeah! It was a Wolfman, baby.
Okay, Greg.
Let's go with magazines, Bob.
Magazines for $100. You have $550. Time magazine was founded by two reporters from the Baltimore News. One was Britton Hayden. Who was the other?
Otis Chandler.
No, Dori.
I don't know.
Save your team, Leanne.
George Plimpton.
Sorry, no. Henry Luce. Henry R. Luce. You're frozen at $550. Let's go back to our seniors. You have $200. Trying to get to $1,000. Jordan, let's get them now.
Satellite.
Satellite. For $100, seniors, come on now. What was the name of the first U.S. satellite to orbit the Earth?
Voyager.
Sorry. Linda.
Sputnik.
Sorry.
Challenger.
No. Sputnik? Is that what you said?
I went to the wrong country.
Where do you live, Linda? Explorer 1 was the answer we were looking for. You're frozen at $200. Back to the juniors. Greg, pick a question.
Let's go with cult.
Cult. For $100, juniors, what's the stage and screen name of cult comedy actor Richard Marin? I don't know, Dori?
I don't know.
Leanne, save your team.
I have no idea.
No idea in the world? Well, let me tell you, his partner is Chong. Who would it be?
Cheech.
Cheech, yes. You're frozen at $550. Back to the seniors we go.
Come
all right, Jordan.
Monroe.
Monroe. Oh. I knew you would. You have $200 trying to get to $1,000. What was Marilyn Monroe's last completed film?
The Misfits.
That's right, The Misfits. Yeah! Got there just in time. $300. All right, Linda.
Let's try drug.
Which one? Drug. The lady wants to try drugs. Tylenol has come out with a cross between a tablet and a capsule. What do they call it?
Capsulette?
No.
Spansel?
Sorry. That's it. You were very close. A caplet.
Oh.
A caplet. You said capsulette. You're frozen at $300. Back to the juniors with $550. Greg?
Let's go with business.
Business. For $100, juniors, in Gone with the Wind, what business did Scarlett O'Hara go into after the Civil War ended?
Tailoring.
No, Dori.
Fashion.
Fashion won't do it. Leanne?
Farming.
Sorry again. She went into the lumber business. Seniors, you have $300. Trying to get to $1,000. Linda, pick a question.
Let's try Cannon.
Cannon. For $100, seniors, who played the TV detective Cannon?
Well, Conrad.
Conrad, William Conrad. Good enough. Now you have $400, Brooke.
Let's go with Bond.
Bond for $100. In James Bond's films, Bond's boss is called M. Who is M's secretary?
Henny Penny.
No.
Penny Whistle.
No.
Miss
Linda.
Money Penny.
Pardon me?
Miss Money Penny.
Money Penny is the right answer, yes. Penny, 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 whistle, money, penny. All right. You have $500. Brooke, if you would please pick a question.
Country music.
Okay, let me tell you, we've asked 10 questions. So hereafter, every question is worth $200. Each team has, no, you have 500, they have 550. Here we go, for $200. Name the country superstar whose hits include Dang Me, Chug-a-Lug, and Do-Wack-a-Doo.
John Denver.
No.
Roger Miller.
That's Roger Miller, yes. Now, seniors, with $700. Linda, pick a question.
Sinatra.
Sinatra. In what film did Frank Sinatra play a priest? Brooke.
Monsignor.
Do you know, Jordan?
Mystery of the Bells. Miracle of Bells.
Did he get there on time? Did not get there in time. I'm sorry. It was Miracle of the Bells, yes. For Sinatra to pray a priest, it was a miracle of the bells, yes.
Sure was.
You're frozen at $700. Back to the juniors we go with $550. Greg, pick one.
Let's try artists, Bob.
Artists. For $200, juniors. Come on now. What film told the story of Vincent Van Gogh?
My Life.
Dori.
Starry Night?
No, Leanne.
Lust for Life.
Lust for Life is right, yes. Now, $750. Come on, Greg.
Let's go with theme.
Theme. For $200, juniors. Who wrote and sang the theme song for the TV series Chico and the Man?
Oh, Jose Feliciano.
That's right, Jose Feliciano. You only need one more, Dori, to remain champion. Pick a question.
I'll go for 60s films.
60s films. You have $950. If you get this one right, you win the game and a chance to play for $10,000. In 1961, Anne Margaret made her screen debut in A Pocket Full of Miracles, in which her character was reunited with the mother she had never met. Who played her mother? Leanne.
Betty Davis.
Your champions, that's right, Betty Davis. Our juniors remain champions. They made a comeback, didn't they? The end of a $700 seniors. You're nice people. Thank you so very much for being with us. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
To see you. Bye-bye now. All right, congratulations, juniors. We'll be back in just a moment to see if they can't win $10,000. See you in a minute. Welcome back to Trivia Track. And juniors, our champions, come in here. All right, congratulations to you. Done it again, returning champions. Yesterday, Leanne won the $10,000. Let's see all of you get involved in that big money today. If you are ready, I want you to go right over there and get in position because we're going for a pot of gold worth $10,000. Good luck. Now, up until now, as you know, you played as partners, but now you're on your own. You try to win some money for yourself. And there you are, Leanne, right in the old number one position, which means you have the opportunity to play or pass on the first set of answers. If you're ready, Leanne, Greg, and Dori, let's begin our climb up our trivia ladder as we go to the first level and take a look at the answers. And here we go. There they are, skeletons, red devils, suits of armor, spiders. What do you think, Leanne? You want to play? You want to pass?
I'm going to give it to Greg.
Pass those on down to Greg. Greg, what do you want to do? You want to play or pass?
I'm going
to
pass it.
Pass them to Dori? Dori,
I guess
the question
I'll play.
Is yours. Yes, it's worth $1,000 if you get it right. You get $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000. Here's the question. In the new Jackson video, Torture, what is seen break dancing? I need the correct answer, Dori.
Skeletons.
You say it's skeletons. For $1,000. A chance to play for $10,000. For Dori, is it skeletons? Yes. Congratulations to you. You now have $1,000, Dori.
Oh, yeah.
And you'll join us at the top to play for $10,000. Let's go again now to the next level of our ladder for Leanne and Greg. And here we go. The answers this time are Eddie Fisher and daughter, Pat Boone and daughter, Frank Sinatra and daughter, or Bing Crosby and daughter. Leanne, play or pass?
I'll play.
I'll play for $1,000. A chance to play for $10,000. Mm. What father and daughter team had a number one hit in 1967 with the song Something Stupid? Correct answer, please. Something Stupid. Answer, please.
Pat Boone and daughter.
Pat Boone and daughter. Audience says, oh, Dori ducked her head. But hang on, let's find out. Is it Pat Boone and his daughter? No, it is Frank Sinatra and his daughter.
That was
Leanne,
my second choice.
We say goodbye to you for today. Thank you very much, and we'll see you tomorrow. All right, Greg. Now, if you're ready, let's find out if you're going to join Dori up on the top for the $10,000. Let's move right up to our next level now. And these answers you must play. They are bag, trap, oven, sty. Greg, here's your question. We've all heard the expression, I've got a pig in a poke. Greg, what is a poke?
Let's go with oven, Bob.
Oven, you say. All right. Got a pig in your oven. Let's see if that's the correct answer for $1,000. How about it? Is it an oven? No, it's not. A poke is a bag. Pig in a poke is a bag. Greg, we say goodbye to you. You'll be back tomorrow to join Dori and Leanne. Thank you very much for being with us today. All right, Dori, now, you've got the $1,000. Let's see if you can't pick up the $10,000. Let's go right up to the top of our ladder for Dori. And here it is. What was the first U.S. car manufactured. First U.S. car, manufactured. Now, Dory, it's worth $10,000. Is it Ford, Buick, Chrysler, or Oldsmobile?
I'm not very good with cars. I'll guess Oldsmobile.
You want to guess Oldsmobile? Dory, come down here. It's just you and me. We might as well suffer through this together. It's for $10,000. The audience says, oh, I would have guessed Ford. Let's see. For $10,000, is it Oldsmobile? It is! Tomorrow's a team, they won over $24,000. Until tomorrow, I'm Bob Eubanks saying so long from all of us at Trivia Track. Bye-bye.
Hi, Dad.
Hi.
I don't really need your help, but I just wanted to let you know that I'm going to win the $1 million. Because the U.S. president appeared on Laugh-In as Richard Nixon, that's my final answer.
He's won $1 million!